Okay, here we've been around 60 years. Here's some of the pictures that we've taken through the years. Here's my grandma, Grandpa Brown in Minnesota. Here's a picture of Edith, Grandma and Grandpa Totes. They came from England. Here's my folks' wedding picture. And here's Edith's folks' wedding picture. Both of them. Here's a picture of my baby picture. And here's Edith's baby picture. Here's part of our family, part of us kids, Melvin, myself, and Leroy, and my sister Ruth. Leroy is the one with the little grandson. We lived in Minnesota 3 years after the folks were married. I was born in Minnesota. And this is the first place we lived down in South Dakota. We moved down there on the train. I think it took us 2 days to get down there. My Uncle George Schindeberger and Arthur Delmage is in Rutland to help us unload the cars.
Didn't you say there was a stockyards in Rutland at that time?
Yeah, there used to be the stockyards that we unloaded the livestock at in Rutland. At that time, it was 1910.
Your dad, or your granddad, bought the place. That was his place that you moved on to, wasn't it?
Mm-hmm. Here's a picture of Melvin, Leroy, and I, Lucille, and my sister Ruth. Here's a picture of my sister Ruth. She was going to normal school in Madison. That was just before she was grown. This is the boat that they went down in the lake. Here's a picture of my family, all but Edith.
All but Ruth.
All but Ruth, yeah. Ruth is drowned. Here's a picture of Edith's sister and brother and herself. And there's a picture of the whole family. Edith's family. There's a picture of Edith's dad.
The representative of the state. And
there's a picture of their first car, Edith's folks' Chevrolet car. Here's a picture of her uncle, Uncle Art Totes. He's a bachelor. Here's a picture of Edith and Cassie Lee.
Bigger. That's when I was in high school.
Her name wasn't bigger then.
That's the same day, I think.
Here's a picture of Edith's dad and herself. Here's another picture of Edith. Here's Here's a picture of Edith and I. That before we was married. We went to Sioux Falls to take a plane ride just for the fun of it. There's a picture of Edith and Cassie. There's a picture of my dad and mother. There's a picture of my old car and Leroy and I sitting on it. And there's a picture of Edith's folks. Here's a picture of their home place, Edith's, where they landed when they came from England. Here's Uncle Art and his new Ford. Here's a picture of Edith's dad when he was cutting grain one harvest. That was before we were married. And here's a picture of Edith, again.
It was a winter before we were married, in the summer.
Here's another picture of Edith. Here's a picture of me at Edith's folks' place. And here's a fourth generation picture, Melvin, his daughter Dorothy, and my dad and his mom. There's a picture of Edith and I.
Wedding picture. There's another picture of my wedding picture. I've got my location there. I think all four of us. All four of us were running. Cassie stood up for us. And there's the family group we had at home wedding. And here's a picture of us just before we left on our honeymoon. That's folks' new car. And this is on our honeymoon. We were up at Mount Rushmore, and I told Marvin to laugh, and this is the way he looked. This is the cabin that we stayed in at Rapid City. This is a game lodge out there in the hills where Coolidge stayed. We ate there one day. And there's an eagle's eye. Out in the hills, that was on our honeymoon. Here's another picture on our honeymoon. This is a picture of Marvin one morning just before he went out to plow. And I told him to smile and laugh, and that's what he done. Here's a four-generation picture of on Marvin's mother's side, Lucille and Leroy and his mother and Grandma Brown. And this is a four-generation on Melvin's side. And it's Grandma Brown and Grandma Pickard and Dorothy Melvin. And here's a picture of us. After we've been married 2 years, we kind of look like we're a little worn. And about that time, Cassie got married. And that's our wedding picture, her wedding picture, and Louie and I stood up for it. And there's the family group. There's a picture of Darlene and Audrey. That's so cute. This is about a year later, or 2 years later, we got Bernadine and Dolores added to it. In 1935, we got a new Chevy, our first new car. mother had a picture taken of it. Here it is again. This is when we lived up on the highway in 77, you know, same car. This is Bill Anita's wedding picture. I and who stood up with her then? I don't remember who stood up with Bill. I know I stood up with Edith. There's Darlene and Ivan. Darlene was just a little jigger. I mean, she was yet about a year and a half. And here she is about two. She stood on our cistern top for the picture taking. She had a new snowsuit, so she was real proud of it. And mother was up to see us, and she had a picture taken with Darlene. This is Darlene, her dad. She's posing there, it looks like. This is a picture of Dolores on her first birthday. Darlene and Dolores. I had a big picture taken of that. It was so pretty, all glass. But Dolores was so proud of it that she kept climbing on top of the piano to get it. She knocked it off one day and broke it, so I took care of that one. Here's, Uncle Art used to give the girls his orphan lambs. Here they are with a couple of them. And here's another picture of them. I don't know if that's the same year or not. Every year he gave them some. Now this is a picture of our house before we took the stucco off and closed the porch, I guess that's what you'd call it. And that's you and this picture of me and Darlene's dog, Lassie, isn't it? Mm-hmm. And here's Darlene and Dolores with skates. I imagine they're ready to go skating.
And this is our house when we first moved it down here. It was a stucco house. We moved it from Colton. We took the stucco all off and put siding on it. It took us 3 days to bring it up here. And here's a picture of Edith and I. One winter was we were ready to go to church. I guess this is Darlene and Dolores. There's a couple more of the lambs that I've already given. They give them some every year. So some orphan lambs they give them for girls. There was no buildings here on the place when I moved here. So we put up the buildings and we just finished the barn. This is myself and two girls. Here's another one. See? Here's another picture of Edith and I. Kind of goofing off. They're much younger than me. Here's a picture of the building we put over the wall for the pump house. Bob Lee used to work for me. I've got him doing the dishes and I'm standing over him and see if he does it right. Here we're getting along a little better. He's washing dishes and I'm wiping them. Here's a picture of the place after we got the buildings all put up. You see we got a bunch of little trees out there, we put up a windbreak. Here's a picture of Darlene.
It's her graduation.
There's a picture of me in my first truck. I started trucking in about 1945. There's kind of a story behind this pickup. I drove down to Coleman one day and parked it alongside of Harold Nelson's pickup. He had one just like it. He had an appointment in Brookings to get his fender fixed. He took my pickup instead of his, so he got up there and couldn't find the fender to fix. So he had to come back and get his own pickup. There's Darlene and Fritz up there waiting. There's another picture of Darlene and Fritz. They were living in Oklahoma. And Linda was born. She's just a baby there. There's a picture of Edith. Here's a picture where we're taking the stucco off the house and putting siding on it. Here's a picture of Dolores, and I think she was in high school. This is her graduation picture. Here's a picture of me kind of goofing off on a garden tractor that I'd bought. That's just another picture of Edith and I. I went to Sioux Falls and bought a new corn shiller. Bob Ralph was driving for me at that time, and Bob Lee was working for me. Here's a picture of our first trailer. Here's Edith, Dolores, and Richard, and their wedding picture. There's another picture there, wedding. And here's a picture of our family at the wedding. This is a picture of Richard's folks and Edith and I at Dolores and Richard's wedding. Here's a picture of the shiller after we got it on the other truck and shelling corn. Here's a picture of my first trailer when I started hauling. Here we are again with the showing the picture of the truck. I also had a roller mill added to it and shelled and rolled at the same time. There's another picture of the trailer. There's a picture of Dolores and Richard when Todd was born. Here's a picture of me holding Todd, trying to put him to sleep, but he didn't go to sleep very good.
Well, it's Cindy and Linda with a cowboy hat on.
Well, why don't you tell them, talk to them, you know where they are.
Here's a picture of Todd and all the kitties. He just loved kitties. And there's both Marvin's critters. There's Marvin on the tractor with Todd. And Marvin got me a fur coat for about one winter, and we were over to Melvin's for dinner, and there we got the time over this fur coat, so Melvin put it on, and we had our pictures taken. It was over at Melvin's. Here's a picture of Barney and both the girls, and the laddie. Here's a picture taken out of Darlene and Fritz's. I think it was one Easter. The girls are quite grown up. And here's Christmas. It's Linda, Simeon, Todd, and Grandma. And this is just the kids in the kitchen at our place here. I think this was taken one Easter, and the girls were all dressed up in their Sunday best. This is one time the girls were down here. Rick must have been a baby. This is Rick. He was only about a year older, a little older. And he was so tricky. He was climbing up on the desk and he shouldn't be there. And I was telling him no, and he just laughed and didn't go ahead anymore. This is how we made a go-kart for the kids. And they were all down here, I think. This is Linda and Cindy again, all dressed up in there. This is when they had this wreck at, where was that, Hartford?
Humboldt.
Humboldt, yeah, Humboldt.
Well, the wreck, we just tipped
over. Well, they tipped over. This is after they tipped them back up again. And there's the trailer again. I don't know which one. I need to tell what that's a period.
Well, I was county commissioner here. I was commissioner for 20 years. And they had the fair in Flandre, and they had a car for us to ride in during the parade. And here's a picture.
Divorce is for.
We celebrated our 50th anniversary and we were down to Walton Marys for supper.
Here's our 40th.
Okay. And here's the same time, you know. This picture of Edith Knight. Here's a picture of Darlene and her family, Fritz and Linda, Cindy and Kevin.
That's a birthday of somewhere for Doris, I'm sure.
Here's a picture of my first straight truck. And here's a picture of
Dusty.
He just little dog.
You're so sweet.
Here's a picture of Melvin and I and Leroy and Ruth and Edith and Lucille. This is our first trip out to Arizona. It's the hotel we stayed at. Here's a picture, I don't remember the name of that mountain, but you can see the road going up there over the hill is the International Proving Ground. So we wanted to go up to see that, but they wouldn't let us in. While we're up on the mountain, we took a picture in back of Phoenix and Mesa, Tempe. They're almost all together there down in the valley. Here's a picture. My pickup and my boat, I guess I was going fishing. There's a picture of my trailer just back in the shed. And here's a later picture of this. I got a new tractor. There's a picture of Edith and Bill and Cassie's. Here's a picture of me, and I don't remember the fellow's name, but I was receiving a plaque from the commissioners. And that's my pickup. There's a picture of Edith and I. Picture of Edith and I.
That's our 50th anniversary.
Here's a picture of Edith Mayan and her cousin from England come over to spend the summer with us. It's a picture of Edith Mayan.
Oh, that was at our open house.
A picture of Todd emceeing our program on our 50th anniversary.
Here's a picture of Edith and I. Anniversary, that was.
It was a 50th anniversary cake.
These are all at the same time.
Here's another one. We've been married 50 years at that time.
That's very disappointing, isn't it?
That's Melvin's wife pouring the coffee there. Here's a picture of Cassie and
Deborah, isn't it? That's something Gary, isn't it?
But that was at your anniversary, or pouring punch or something. Indian Gary.
Well, he was riding either Kevin's motorbike or Gary's, I don't know which one, Donna Darlene's servant, Kevin's motorcycle.
He must have decided that was too big for him because the next one looks like it fits him better.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, then he took his three-wheeler. Then Tom took a picture of all the trucks.
Well, I used to haul feed out to ranch out in Rapid City, and then I'd bring a load of lumber back, and I'm just getting ready to load lumber. And here we are living.
Well, that's Lana's birthday. I don't know which one, but I know it's her birthday.
And here's a picture, I don't remember where I was going that day. I think I was going out to Harold. Todd wanted to get a picture of the trucks and the pickups. That's his pickup and my pickup and the three trucks. Here's a picture of Bill and Baldwin. Picture Cassie and Clint, I don't know.
50th.
It's our 50th anniversary. There's a picture of Roy and Cassie and his wife.
And their
50th. And their anniversary. And there's Cassie and Clint and Edith and a couple of their cousins from England.
Yeah, it's taken in England. Glenn and Jill's place. Yeah, we were on our way to London to Jill and Glenn's, and this was about halfway, and we stopped here for lunch. And I'll take a picture. I'll take the English pictures. Here's a picture of our mother, of the church that Mother and Uncle Bob used to sing in, Earl Shelton. Now this is Bill and Edith's 50th anniversary. And here's the sisters and the brother-in-laws of our side of the family.
This is just a picture of our house in winter. You can see the snow around it. Here's another picture on a different side of the house. Another picture of the house, and it's taken in the summertime. You can see the flowers I wonder. There's a picture of Dolores and Richard. And
the 25th.
The 25th anniversary, and they're wishing a picture of Dolores and Richard.
Same day.
There's a picture of the whole group there. There's a picture of myself and Edith and her up for Richards.
This is a picture of Linda and Dale, their wedding picture. And then Methodist Church in Flandreau. Several years later, this is the tribe they came up with, Katie, Crystal, and Carrie. And this is a picture of Gary and Cindy in the same Methodist church.
Is that their wedding picture?
It's their wedding picture.
Mm-hmm.
Cindy and Gary cutting their wedding cake. And we never had to postpone the wedding for a week or two waiting for Linda to have her baby, but she finally had her, and this is her in the picture here. Katie was just about 17 days old, I guess. This is a picture of the house that Cindy and Gary built right after they were married, down by Hartford. And this is a picture of Cindy and Gary in Colorado on vacation. And since they have no children, we don't have any children's pictures, so this is the most recent picture of them that they had taken.
Yeah, this is Todd and Wendy's wedding, 1980, and all the ones that stood up with them. And this is a recent picture of Todd and Wendy and Lacey and Samantha. This is a picture of Rick and Deb, and our family picture of their wedding. And this is a recent picture of their family at Kristen's baptism, Danielle and Kristen.
Well, it's just a picture of Wendy's place. Wendy's out there, she's been watering her flowers. Yeah, sure. And this is a picture of Marvin and Orion Melvin, three brothers. I don't know when that was taken, not just lately.
It's in the Nunda basement.
Oh.
The church basement.
Over in Nunda, the church there, the basement. It was at Uncle Melvin's, 85th birthday.
Well, this is a picture of most of my family. I guess all the ones that happened to be there.
This must have been one of our anniversaries when and all the kids were home. We had a picture taken. This is our 55th anniversary. And that's our cake. And Dolores made her, Darlene, I remember which.
This is a picture taken out north of Rapids Hill at a ranch where I was unloading air corn. There's a picture of our tractor when I first got it.
And this is a picture of us, when the group picture when our cousins were here from England. It's a picture of Cassie's birthday party, and this is one's over there. Our picture, we've been married 57 years on that, she says. And this is my birthday party over at Wendy's. And this is my birthday party at Wendy's the same day.
Okay. Now this is a picture of Kevin and Kim at their wedding. And Kevin now lives in Atlanta, Georgia, and he works for Delta. And this, we went out to see them at Christmas time, and this is a picture of Fritz and I and Brittany and Brianna. And she wanted to go, Brittany wanted so bad to go to the Christmas Eve service, but everybody was so tired. It was a candlelight service, so we kind of faked it and had our own around the Christmas tree. It pleased her anyway. And this is Gary and Fritz. Gary and Kevin and Kim and Brianna in front of their fireplace in their new house. And this is what their new house looks like. And this is a picture of Brittany and Brianna in their new Christmas dresses.
There's at the parade in Canada, and they wanted me as parade marshal. We were in the parade. This is my last year as commissioner.
He just had surgery, so he wasn't up to much.
This is Reed and Alice's wedding, our family picture. And this is Reed and Alice and the grandparents. This is a more recent picture of Reed and Alice and Melissa.
That must have been when we had the 55 Club here, huh?
Well, this is our whole family picture that was just taken just a short time ago.
Yeah, that was at the baptism.
Christmas baptism.
And here's Grandpa and a great bunch of little great-grands, but that wasn't all of them.
That was at his 85th birthday.
Mm-hmm. And here's a picture of Marvin and I, as we are now.
That's the picture of our home place here, taken from the air. And what year it is.
This is our gift to you folks for your 60th anniversary. We hope you've had a happy one. I know you'll never forget the times we've had trying to put this together. I just want to wish the folks a happy 60th anniversary and thank them for helping us with this and for the patience that they've had with us in doing this. And we wish them many more happy anniversaries.